In addition to being used to identify preferred vendors for your association, service contracts can also be used to automatically code and approve invoices or override board approval settings. Let's go take a look at how we can use association service contracts to make our task of approving invoices easier. We start at the Association Services page. Click the drop-down arrow for the service and either use the New Contract button to create a new service contract or the Edit button to edit an existing contract. We can search for the service provider from your management company's global service provider list by typing in the provider field. The account number is required in order to use auto approval criteria for service contracts. This is the account number that your service provider has assigned to you. If your service provider has not yet assigned you an account number, you can create a new account number unique to this contract. It is important for us to stop here and note that a unique account number for the service provider and association must be used on each service contract in order for automatic approvals to work. When creating account numbers, we advise that the account number you assign be long enough and unique enough to not potentially be recognized in error on another service contract. The start date is required, but the end date can be left blank. Setting an end date will cause any automatic contract settings to be canceled on the date specified. You can use the description box to enter information about your contract, which can be helpful in referencing contracts that you have previously set up. For our first example, we will use the description of landscaping contract with an auto approval if under $500. Let's go to the approval section to set up our auto approval criteria. For this example, the landscaping contract pays a $500 invoice every month. We will set the amount to $500. The exact amount method will only apply your auto approval criteria if the amount of the invoice exactly matches the number listed in the amount field. The less than amount method will automatically approve invoices less than the amount defined in the amount field. The within amount from last invoice method will automatically approve the invoice if it falls within the amount defined in the amount field. For this example, we will use the auto approve method of exact amount. The board approval and signature approval settings will, by default, follow the settings configured on the Association Settings page in the AP section. However, Vantica allows you to override those association settings per contract. There are options to require board or signature approval, opt for no board or signature approval, or to use association settings. This association does not require board or signature approval, so we can simply use the association settings here. Please note, you must have the appropriate securities to edit signature approval settings. Now we need to define which GL we want those invoices coded to by going to the GL Details section. Click the New GL Item button to add a new GL and begin typing to search in the GL Account field to select from the GL accounts set up for this association. The fund will always default to the operating, but we can override here if we need to pay this invoice out of the reserves. The description will be the GL description used for any invoices approved through this service contract. Because our invoice is always $500, we can either set that amount here or we can just leave the amount column blank. If we want to pay half of this invoice out of one GL and half out of another, we can click to add a new GL item, select our other GL, and then enter the percentages to be paid out of that invoice total. Let's use 50-50 for this example. Once our service contract has been set up, be sure to click Update and Save Changes. Now that your service contract is set up, we'll go take a look at how the service contract works. When an invoice is being coded from the Complete Data Entry screen with the designated association, service provider, and account number correctly identified, users select the Refresh GL button to automatically populate the service contract information. As we can see here from our example earlier, our percentages and GL amounts correctly populated based on our association service contract. Nice work! Let's go back and take a look at another example on the Association Services page. Let's create a new service for the electric utility, and then we will click the drop-down to create a new contract. We will search to select our test utility provider, enter the account number and a start date for the contract. The description of this contract will be auto approval and board override for the utility bills under $100. Now to set up our approvals. We will click on the approval section. For the amount, we will use $100 and our auto approve method, less than amount. In this scenario, we want to override board approval. Our board treasurer always wants to pay the bill and is fine with them being automatically approved if under $100. Therefore, we select the board approval setting of no board approval. Finally, we will set up our GL information by clicking on the GL details section. We click the new GL item button to type and begin searching for our GL in the GL account field. We will enter a description as well. Because utility bills fluctuate, we can leave the amount column blank and click update to save our changes.
For other videos, check out our knowledge base section at vantica.zendesk.com.